Hello, foodie beauties.
Well, hello.
Hi.
Well, we have some BK, my favorite. And it's been like a few days since I had BK, so. Actually, it's been like more than a week. So, let's get two. They have really good deals at the Burger King here in Kuwait. So, I will take advantage of that. Oh. Alright. Okay. French fries. French fries, French fries, French fries, French, French fries. I'm hyper today. Can you tell? Alright! Okay, let me set this up. I'll be right back. Book mice. Living in a library. Book twice. Cheeseburger. And last but certainly not least, we have some chicken fries. Yes. Cheers. Okay. Stump this all out. I got a thumbnail. So much for that. Okay, so Bismillah, thank you so much for this food. I love chicken fries with barbecue. Ketchup mayo, mayo chip. Coca-Cola. The only thing I don't like is the lack of fountain drink when you take order out. Slow down. You're gonna get the hiccups, foodie beauty. So, what's up, guys? Today, I thought I would talk about this whole Snow White movie fiasco. Baby Gail. Initially, when I heard about it, I was like, what? Why are they changing it so much? You know? But then I looked more into it. A lot of people are like outraged because they're like, this woke culture is getting ridiculous, you know? But when you really think about it, older Disney movies do have like a bad rap of using racial stereotypes and just stereotypes in general. So they're trying to, you know, move away from that. And they're damned if they do and they're damned if they don't, because look at the reception they're getting, you know, already. Now, here's the thing. The Rachel Ziegler is the actress who's going to play Snow White. She's Hispanic. Now, the most important thing about the description of Snow White, which is literally in the name, is that She has pale skin as white as snow, red lips, blah blah blah, as red as a rose. The person playing, like Rachel Zegler, is still pale skin, so she's white. Like, she looks white to me, you know? So, her being white, Snow White being white skin, I mean, there's people from different cultures who are white skin, right? So.
And I have to say, if you look at the history of Disney princesses, most of them were white or Caucasian. So it is nice to see them reinventing the Disney princess, basically, with involving other cultures. Beautiful women from all cultures and races.
It doesn't really matter. The Seven Dwarfs. The way they portrayed the dwarfs in the old movie in the 30s. Made people with dwarfism, you know. People argue that it painted them in a light seeming more unintelligent. To me, the dwarfs, I don't think they were supposed to be like human people. Were they supposed to be human in the story? Like, I think they're just like supposed to be short creatures, not human, not saying anything about people with dwarfism, you know? So, I don't know, that could be argued. But how they chose to go about the seven dwarfs are like, there's a freaking hippie. Like, what the heck? And there is still one individual with dwarfism in there. So why not give more people with dwarfism jobs? More actors with dwarfism jobs? I don't know. Like, I get their reasoning. The problem is, I get both sides of the argument now. I see what Disney's doing. At first I was like, it's not Snow White. Because for me, I have the nostalgia of growing up with, you know, the cartoon. So I'm okay now with, I don't mind the actress being from a different culture, whatever, different race. I mean, who cares about that? She's still white. She's Hispanic, but she's white. She has white skin. But, I see what they're doing with the seven dwarfs. Okay. Now there's another part of the argument. I put barbecue sauce on my burger. I love barbecue sauce. Sorry. I like licking my fingers. So a lot of people are like, I don't get people. I think people just like to argue. Because women have been striving and enjoying girl boss movies forever now. And now they're like criticizing that, you know, the actress was like, it's not 1937 anymore, Snow White is gonna save herself and she doesn't need a prince. You know, she's not the helpless damsel in distress anymore. And people are arguing that on TikTok. Like, One woman was like, maybe I want to be saved by my husband. My husband completes me, blah, blah, blah. Okay. My opinion? You should be a complete person on your own. I know that seems weird coming from someone who is married, but like, I I'm still an independent person on my own, you know? I'm not helpless as a woman. And I think that's what I'm trying to go for. So some of the criticisms, like, I get, but I also get what the movie's going for. So it seems people want a good old traditional Disney Snow White movie. But I think if they did that, people would be crying about the stereotypes and the fact that it's outdated for society's standards nowadays. And it probably is, you know? The movie they made in 1937 was according to the attitudes and standards of 1937, but it's 2023. So you have to expect some change. So I get that. I get that now. So I don't know. I still don't think I'm gonna watch it, but after all that, I'm like, I'll probably not watch it. I don't know. I remember Pete saying this before, and he's so right. Sometimes childhood movies and you know, stories are just not enjoyable as an adult without the nostalgia. So that's absolutely true. So because the story for me is not going to be nostalgic, like the new movie, I don't think I'll enjoy it. You know? The spicy chicken sandwich, chicken royal. Yum. I have to agree with that. Anyway, I see all sides of it. You know, I kind of respect Disney not wanting to repeat their past with that, you know, so They have Oppenheimer now at the theaters here. But it's PG-13 here. I don't know if it was in Canada or US. I don't really, it's a long movie, 3 hours. I don't know if I have an interest in the atomic bomb. To be honest. But it's gotten like 94% on Rotten Tomatoes. As a rating from critics, 93 from audience, which is good. Sometimes there's a big disparity between the two. Big difference. Look at me using big words. But I have the same problem with Barbie movie, like, you know, bringing things from the 80s that I had nostalgia about as a kid. Barbie was a toy, like, for me. It wasn't, I don't know. The new Barbie movie, just from the trailer, doesn't give me any nostalgia feeling, so. I wonder if the Beetlejuice, they're working on a Beetlejuice 2 movie, apparently. They've been working on it forever, but they're actually, like, setting up the set where they filmed the original one, I think in Vermont. Like, the Maitland's hardware store, and, you know, it, really beautiful state. So if they're actually filming, that would be amazing. Unless it's very different from the first, I don't know. But Beetlejuice is such a classic, you know. It's gonna be hard to one up that one. That movie has a lot of nostalgia for me because I loved that movie growing up. One of my favorite. I was a weird kid. I liked weird, creepy things even back then. Are You Afraid of the Dark? I think it's a Canadian show, but Unsolved Mysteries. Robert Stack was my granddad growing up in my home. I did see my grandfather a lot. But, like, in my home, Robert Stack's voice was always a comfort, you know? Anyway. This is what happens when I let myself get too hungry, but that was so good. the spicy chicken burger from Burt BK. BK fries are not bad for fast food fries. The worst fast food fries, I have to say, are Wendy's. I hate their fries. Anyway, so let me know your thoughts. Respectfully, having a constructive debate in comments is always welcomed. We can share differences of opinions without attacking each other. And yeah, I was having some fun on TikTok, just like waiting for my food to get here, trying all the different trends I hate so much. Some of them are fun, some of the filters. So check that out if you want. And yeah, so anyways, I guess that's it. Yeah, that's my opinion. I don't really have a strong one. You know, looking more into it, I get their reasoning now. So anyway, let's talk to you later. Bye.